I think the forum or this conference, Islam-Confucianism Leadership Dialogue, is very meaningful in bringing different people of different backgrounds together and also building bridges so that we understand each other better and to make sure we can continue Malaysia, the different civilization can continue to find commonalities and also to embrace our differences.
Thank you, YD.
Thanks.
The event was really successful and it's a very remarkable and historical moment as we mark another milestone on the Islam and Confucianism dialogue. As you seen on the opening ceremony, PM and Dr. Professor Tu Wei Ming had a conversation over a video conference, and I felt very touched, and because I still can remember back to 20-30 years ago lah, the first ever similar conference has been carried out, and today we witnessed another conference together Dr. Tu Wei Ming and Yamat Bohomat, Perdana Menteri. So I really looking forward for all this civilization dialogue ahead and flourish in other event.
Thank you, YB.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Confucianism can be considered a philosophy, an approach to life. And there are areas of Confucianism pertaining to humanity, equality, transparency, etc., etc., which are also the pursuits of other religions, including Islam. So in areas where there are overlaps, in areas where people are able to harmonize their interests without necessarily sacrificing their religion, then I think Muslims also can partake in this kind of life.
Thank you, sir.
I'm Professor Muhammad Abu Bakar, former lecturer at the University of Malaya.
Thank you, sir.
Ini apa ni?
This is a question.
Can you wrap up what your message at the stage?
Okay. Basically, I was introducing a project called Ethica 101 Meridian Grids. What I mean by the project simply this, that we need to revisit all the global orders which are currently not delivering their public goods like education, security, whatsoever. So I think it's about time for Malaysia to take this ambitious project, which I call it a global ethical governance project.
Okay.
So on that note, I'm not presumptuous. I invite everyone, because I think it must be some wisdom in the Islam and Confucianism, because why? They managed to transform people, nations, and until today, two countries which represent this, Malaysia and China, are showing a lot of potential with a very good stories. I think we need to use that advantage in the form of project so that we can achieve something. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
All right. My name is Yusmadi Yusof. For this program, I'm a deputy chairman for the program, and I'm also a former senator, member of parliament, and also a former adjunct professor at ISTAC.
Yeah.
All right. This morning, our Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim said about a very important things, that this is an era for a global ethical governance. So he believed that values is the most important thing, not only about material wealth or growth. So it's about time we need to address all the current challenges, can be inequality, poverty, technological, whatsoever, artificial intelligence. But above all, from his point of view, is about ethics. So I think it is an era of global ethical governance.
Thank you, sir.
So every people and every citizen have to observe or adhere to one religion. Thank you very much. I introduce myself. My name last year, professor in Chinese philosophy, but I also teach on Confucianism at Gajah Mada University.
Hello, my name is Azizan Baharudin. I am from the Center for Civilizational Dialogue, University of Malaya. And I think this conference is very important because we need more dialogues between people of various faith groups so that we can find common values for finding solutions of our common problems.
Your student.
10 minutes or so will close the session.
Okay, come. All right. Thank you.
Okay.
I'm Halim Muhammad Said from Gomba. I've been attending this conference on Confucianism and Islam, and I found it very enlightening. There's so many things I've learned for the past one day, and I hope that there will be more civilizational dialogue, not only between Islam and Confucianism, but all the rest of the ideologies.
Okay.
And civilization
come
much. Together, have dialogue for a peaceful world.
Okay, I understand you can speak Mandarin.
I can speak Mandarin, but I'm not comfortable in it now.
Okay, all right. You have been learning it?
Because I haven't been practicing speaking it.
But you have been practicing for 10 years, right?
I've been learning.
Okay, all right. Can you speak just one sentence?
Oh, buhe jiang hanyi.
Thank you. Okay, alright.
Okay, saya Fahmi Samsudin, Naib Presiden ABIM. Saya mengucapkan terima kasih dan mengalulkan semua yang hadir ke program yang sangat penting Islam and Confucianism yang diadakan hari di Kuala Lumpur.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
My name is Amir Zekrugu. I'm a professor at the University of Melbourne. I've been residing in Malaysia for some 23 years. I served as a professor of Islamic and Oriental arts, so I'm a comparative religion scholar, especially Buddhism and Hinduism and Islam. So now I'm attending this conference on Islam and Confucianism, which is a very interesting subject, not only interesting, but it's very relevant to today's issues, where everything is fragmented and people start dividing according to their thoughts and ideologies and nations and religions and so on. Having a discussion, a dialogue that brings them together is always helpful.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Hi, Assalamualaikum. My name is Muhammad Ahmad Shahmi. I am a student from International Islamic University of Malaysia. I am taking political science, and right now I become a committee for Islam-Confucianism Leadership Dialogue in Renaissance Hotel. Thank you.
Welcome.
Assalamualaikum, Assalamualaikum Malaysia. So today, we are part of the crew for this event actually, and we also a delegation from IIUM, because I believe this is important for us as a academician to acknowledge the importance of dialogue between Islamic perspective and also Confucianism perspective as well. So I think it's a very good discussion, and I hope this event can be benefited by everyone. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Adi Irfan. My name is Adi Irfan, and I'm from IIUM.
Okay.
And this is my team as well. We come here as the delegation from IIUM and also as the crew for this event. And it's a very good initiative from ISTAC and also cross research and search as well. And I hope that this event will be benefited by every participant and audience.
Yes.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Mercy and compassion bring greater value for human beings.
Humanness.
Disciple. Even among the disciples pun dia
ada different level.
Oh yeah.
Different level
understanding. Understanding. Two one. You remember? Two one of his disciple. Is describing what disciple.
He said.
So it is important to discuss to differentiate. Yeah? So but in this case, it is only one category.
Yeah.
The believer. But it's another saying of the Prophet. But there is more ordinary knowledge, lah. More ordinary kind of knowledge, not as special as hikmah, wisdom. Wisdom is a precious thing, you know. But the other knowledge is just, I mean, the
general.
Yeah, general.
Special, like doctor, you got specialist, general doctor. Like
wisdom is a. My name is Osman Bakar. I'm Professor Osman Bakar. I am now a professor at ISTAC, Kuala Lumpur.
What's your message for this event?
Well, I hope and pray that more and more Malaysians in particular, and also people from other places, will appreciate this Islam-Confucian dialogue, and hopefully we move forward, and of course eventually we would like to see this dialogue to embrace other traditions, other religions. So that's it.
Wow, thank you.
Well, I'm a teacher, so I love explaining things to, to people. You ask me questions, I like to answer.
Good.
I've been teachers all this,
Okay.
My first occupation was a school teacher.
Wow.
And then a university teacher.
Okay.
And I'm still a university teacher.
All right.
Good.
Thank you, sir.
If I may add, Prof. Osman is an inspiration. He's my mentor, if I may say so. If my Muslim mentor, I've been very generous. And I've been very generous. And I look forward to have more collaboration.
Yes, yes. And as you say, it's mutual learning.
Yes, sir.
Mutual learning. Teacher benefits from student. Students benefit from teacher.
Thank you, sir.
He's the fountain of the knowledge.
Wow, okay. Right.
Very distinguished academic. She will be speaking about in how these civilization values can help us solve the present planetary health crisis. Professor Azizan has been a very distinguished career. She's been a chairman of the National Interfaith Harmony Committee, membership member in the International Bioethics Committee in UNESCO, and is currently the director of the University of Malaya Center for Civilizational Dialogue. And then we come to Mr. When Professor Osman asked me to be a moderator today, he said that you can choose whichever panel you like. And I looked at the panel and said, oh, this is the one that Faisal is a very old friend and the only one to say very good meeting. Faisal is the outgoing president of ABIM, has been for the last 4 years. He's been extremely active in the interfaith and intercommunal senior Malaysian in Malaysian civil society, which is where I've done a lot of program, and it's a real pleasure to be sitting here. I understand we're running pretty late on time, so we'll have 15 minutes for each speaker, then maybe about 20 minutes for questions and answers. So we do hope that plenty of questions for our panelists, as well as I have asked questions that are very good to ask questions. Just kidding. Please let me sign. Okay. Sit.
Distinguished colleagues, okay, and our workers, teachers, and entrepreneurs. Today, I'm going to report you the macro video of Chinese outstanding Savage is the blood relationship concentrate. Islam encourages the fair distribution of wealth and resources, discourages excessive accumulation of wealth, and emphasizes the concept of economic justice. In the Quran, Surah Al-Hashr, verse 7, yeah, we have Islam embeds principles of social justice, and it discourages excessive. And the translations are translation of the verse, whoever from the possessions counts people, Allah has bestowed on his messenger, that belongs to Allah and the messenger and to his kinfolk, and to the orphans, to the needy, and to the wayfarer, so that it may not merely circulate between the rich among you. So accept whatever messenger gives you and refrain from whatever Allah forbids you and fear Allah badly or vice the most to speak. So in this verse,
the effects of the weather on our life, and we also speak about the impact of what's going on our civilization, because if what's happening to the planet is really bad, then we will not have a civilization to talk about, because there's no planet on them, then what should be done. So here we bring the dialogue was 27 years old and it was institutionalized by the Prime Minister, and this is to counter the Western view at that time, the clash of civilization, by the time of the next. So this topic was so important globally, because we stand at a critical moment in Earth history, a time when humanity must choose its future. As the world becomes increasingly interdependent and fragile, I think we need to understand that the future comes for great dialogues, of course, great policy. So to move forward, we must recognize that in the midst of magnificent diversity of cultures, Islam and Confucianism for each other.
So the podcast is very impactful in terms of the third sector, reducing the burden of the government. So in fact, the revival of what is considered to be.
And I was aware, I was around at that time, and the original version of the book of that conference. Yeah. The sustainability center of the world, I already looked at it.
they say that to solve our problems, you know, we need to put our heads together, we need to think, we need to feel, we need to create with our hands, we need to experience nature so that the solutions that we need for what's happening at the moment, all the crises that we are going through, like they propose through our presentation here, that Islamic and Confucian values can be inputted inside the narrative of this time. Because these are all based on empirical research, but again, spirituality must come. And we have to unpack the word spiritual. What is spiritual? Okay, please. Next slide, please. Next slide. Okay, so we have to change our mindset. Yeah. So as I said, even the Westerners have gone the whole way in terms of ignoring traditional values. Apparently, they come back. Now they are searching for the soul, searching for what needs to be. So next, quickly, so dialogue is critical because when I, as a Christian, dialogue with someone who is, you know, very steeped in Confucianism, I need to have certain ways of doing it so that I will not be rejected by my people and you will not be rejected by your people. Because the problem with dialogue is intra-dialogue. Why are you seeking to all these people? Is there no way to do it? So there are certain do's and don'ts. But what is critical is it is inevitable. And actually, if you give our tradition, this is what we do. Okay, if you have time, maybe you can write this in the right way. Last but not least,
Okay, first of all, thank you for having me to share some time for the workshop. A conversation on the issue of local social nature, that what we can do, what we should do to bring this society forward. Next. Right, next meeting is probably the.
I was around at that time, the original version of the book of
that conference. Right from the best get to the conference between Spain and Russia. The first one for the invasion or the use of force by the Russians to Ukraine territory. And to the east, the persecution done by or committed by the Israeli towards Gaza people. And let alone many different conflicts around the world in many countries that has caused bloodshed. So in other words, we can see now we are facing more challenges in terms of polarized people where we have to face right now and what we should do to overcome these polarized sentiments against others. And at the same time, we have to ask ourselves what is the main cause or the root cause for this escalating of the sentiments or hate sentiments against others. Whether we like it or not, it is derived from us. As we see now, if we see through the social media, we have much information or maybe we see a lot of hate speech info that can be around. And the main issue now, we as a human being, when we receive info, we tend to take position in the first place. When we receive info, for example, now we have a lot of social media spreading many infos. We tend to, even though it is yet to be verified, we tend to decide which one or which side is true, which side is wrong. And we tend to take side and we love to make presumption and to pass judgment. This is our main problem. This judgmental problem, when we receive info, we just all the way make judgment who is right and who is wrong. And in order to reinforce our judgment or our decision, when we receive another info supporting our judgment, we just simply share again anything. And to make things worse, when that kind of info, which contains a lot of hate speech towards others, when maybe it contains violence, for example, we just don't care, we just share, we just spread this info because we want to reinforce our position, our judgment. So, having said so, this is the kind of problem that we have to find out with it. And that's why, if you see, scholars for the future studies name this era as the era of post-normal. Maybe we can't partly agree or not. When we talk about post-normal, now we are in the era of complexity, chaos, and contradiction. Complexity. Now, as I said, when we receive info, info is too much complex, which can cause prevalent behavior that we can control. It was uncertainty. Now we are living in a state of uncertainty because of many contradictions info that we face, that we have right now. And it was or result in chaos and of course contradiction. And because of this, when we live in an era of a lot of contradiction, good of contradiction, chaos and complexity, it was substantial amount of ignorance and as I said, uncertainty. And now we choose to be ignorant. We don't want to fact check, but we just spread all the way info that suit our decision or our judgment or suit our side. And that's the main problem when we talk about this issue of post normal. And of course, and let alone not to mention about this issue of planetary health. Professor has said that shared a lot of planetary health. When I say the world now is a tipping point, this is not just war, but it is also about the resources that we share right now. We fail to see
world is only one that we share together. Because of the development, we want to develop as much and develop as we want. Without taking into consideration about this issue of land that we have, we have to focus on it. And of course, part of the security issue because of the war. And climate degradation, natural disasters. It happens due to climate change or climate crisis. And next. Okay, next. I just keep this for more than that step. Food security and next. Okay, next. Hence, to grab this particular. That's what we talk about. We talk about two characters. We talk about how to encounter the value of two characters. We as human beings, we share this world together. When we talk about civilization, it should not be separated into boxes. It is not a civilization. And when we talk this idea of post-modern Islam, we want to encounter the idea of we survive together, we should thrive together. There is no difficulty between religion or religion. And in fact, just take whoever's father, historian, talk about civilization, all of them agree that there is no contradiction. There is no separation into boxes between civilization. It is not civilization. If you talk about Malaya civilization, Chinese civilization, Indian civilization, it's all about connection. We borrow each other, we borrow expertise from each one another, and at the end of the day, we try together. And that's why we are doing that, for example, he said in his book, the famous story from UK, there is no one piece of God. And he got to also say the same thing. No one nation can claim that you are the truly honor of civilization. When we talk about Roman civilization, we don't talk about Greek civilization. It's not about connection. It's not about how do we benefit from each one in our country. And also, in Confucius, they have this idea of showing balance. They have this idea of how to keep balance from even in the period of warring state period in the past of between Jainism and Taoism. And so during the Han Dynasty, during the emperor of Guri, Confucius became the mentor of the state because of this period of warring. And it comes forward until the ring of the Dynasty of Ming. And we talk about dialogue, we talk about interaction between, for example, in Southeast Asia, archipelago with China, it derived from the Ming Dynasty. The Ming Dynasty, where they have a lot of interaction and dialogue because of this Confucian influence in the Chinese government and also society. And also, not to forget, when we talk about Chongqing, when we talk about Australia, we don't forget, we should not forget about the element of balance brought by Dhammat Iswanapur. My friend, Brother Nasi, and also Brother Craig, talking about this scholar, the famous scholar from Sri Vijaya, from the stream of Vajrayana Buddhism, when they talk about balance or Asasya to be influenced, to be part, to be embedded part of the society. And to that is the problem. This one, we should have more dialogue. And my question, if we have dialogue, when we have, for example, ethno-religious conflict, what comes first in our mind? Do we want to take side first, or do we want to solve the problem? If we don't perceive dialogue as very paramount and important thing, if we face conflict, religious conflict or ethnicity, we tend to take side as Muslims and in that the world will become or remain uncertain. But if we start a dialogue, interaction, when we have problems, when we have conflict, we have controversial issues, what comes first in our mind is the mind of problem. So that is the most important thing for dialogue. We have more interaction, as I say, the issue of Muslims, Chongqing, or
That's where we fit in the gap. But today I was also talking about how disciplinarily speaking, the scientific community seems to be absorbed too much in the physical. I think our Prime Minister has already said something about this when he talks about the MAAI concept. This we should not talk about sustainability purely physical terms only. Speak about the human side. What is it that we want to do now? Humanize the humans. Right? Nothing else than this particular of Bani Adam. We are Homo sapiens. Stand upright and go up. So we have this common platform. Our 99.99% of the DNA and genes in our body, they are all the same. But lo and behold, when people interpret religion, there are various interpretations. So this is where I not want to do. Can we not choose conflict? Can we choose to sit down? Okay, what's wrong? What is it that you believe? What is it that I do? Put it on the table. No, go to your holy book. Does it say when we conflict, we kill each other? No, it doesn't say that. It says other things. So we quote unquote. So can we do it? You say, I say, yes, I say, yes, but we have to look at it. God giving in is next week, I think. Or is it now? But so many conference of parties, tick, 20 times already. And I told you to the rest, it's already giving up. You're marching to find a hell. Because the groups that has to go down, the consumption and all that, are not too equal, not too big. So all these touches upon the other conflicts that we get from the bar. Please be positive and negative, do what you can, do what you can. Surah Al-Zalzalah, whatever little weight of atom of good that you can do, do it. It will be put in government. And not go to government. Zalzalah. So this is already go to us, let us go. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mr. Zalzalah. Sure, please.
The heaven. Social, heaven, human, and the earth together to be in that community, and he has developed his thoughts in 51, 25, 24, the stocks. The 51 stocks to the heaven, 25 to the social, and the 24 to the enterprise. He has developed the heaven, social, and the earth stocks. You know, stocks give it. This is the first thing, reformation. The second, he has developed that the organic food. Organic food for his enterprises and through his hometown to develop the organic food for his enterprise. His employees, his workers could not eat the groceries from the food, eat the food from the groceries, but just lend the food for his employees, for the partners, and together the community around him. So be positive. We could have the community of heaven, social, and earth together as one community that planetary has. Thank you. If you are interested, you can go to China to see, to visit our enterprise and interview our enterprise. And if you are interested now, there is one. You see, in India, he is an example. He is a representative businessman, enterprise to develop the military health business. Okay, thank you. This is our example from China.
Thank you, Ms. Han, and thank you, Mr. Lee, in the back. If you want to get more information later, thank you very much. Are there other questions? Any other questions? So just now,
it's all about, as I said, for example, when we talk about this natural disaster, or natural disaster that we hit, for example, we fail to see that obstacle of religion, faith. What religious point of view when we talk about greed? Even Prophet Muhammad said, one food is enough for two. But now, because of maybe our greed, we want to focus a lot which will force the earth to produce more. That's the most basic thing. We don't talk about deforestation or maybe or even the big issue. Just small thing. People still not. We fail to see from the angle of religious point of view, even Confucian values, for example, sharing the boundaries to God, for example. Because we want to produce, we coerce or we force this earth to produce love or more. And it caused a lot of, for example, we talk about carbon footprint or say the transportation of the meat, for example, it caused many climate crises or climate emergencies that we face right now. So that's the basic thing. The basic thing is that we can carry forward and we can bring to our families. And of course, it is important to talk about forestry or development and so on.
Thank you very much, Mr. Faisal. I'm afraid I think we have run out of time. I just wanted to say, just to remark, I think all of the speakers have spoken the importance of values, shared values, find shared values on common ground. It's something we don't talk a lot about, whether it's climate change or relationship goals, or science, or business, or economics. I think it's a conversation of values.
As well as the moderator for such a wonderful and amazing session. So I believe that they actually shared their words of wisdom and most importantly in a very comprehensive way, share with us that point of view as well. Thank you so much to all the speakers and first our moderator to make it here to the stage. Thank you. As we're following the transit, we are going to proceed to the closing ceremony in a short while. So may I ask for your cooperation to please remain seated, remain in the conference room, remain in the ballroom. Because we are waiting for the next round of panel to wrap up, and then they are going to join us here for the closing session. So at this moment, please feel free to grab the opportunity to enjoy socializing, networking, and some catch up opportunities.
Look further ahead for this inter Civilisational Dialogue, and hopefully someday people will reflect or think that Malaysia deserves to have more enlightened leaders. Malaysia deserves to have more motivated, hopefully this program has at least brought the idea for enlightened leaders to get attention, but it's not easy, it takes time, but the point is, we want to change the situation. We deserve something better. So thank you, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, and a very good evening. All the best to you. Thank you.
Terima kasih kakak kepada Profesor Brother Dr. Osmabahar. Kita berikan tepukan yang paling beruntung di sini dan pastinya kita menghasilkan semua yang ada di sini untuk tampil di pentas pertama untuk kita bergambar secara beramai-ramai. Untuk kita kenal. Terima kasih. Silakan untuk semua menghasilkan bergambar. Dilaksanakan di pentas pertama sebagai perpuncaknya. Untuk kita menyantuni sesi ini sebagai akhirnya dan kenangan-kenangannya untuk acara yang penuh bersejarah yang dilangsungkan pada hari pasti 29 November 2023. Untuk kita merapatkan detik ini bersama dengan juru foto bebas sesuai penanggungan tadi.
dedicated.
We can actually park at the shopping.
Around here, then have to suggest to
talk to him. Then I follow you.
Oh, you ask him suggest.